Good morning everyone and welcome for today's lecture. So in the last lecture we have started the M derived low pass filter. We have seen the equation of what will be the modification in the shunt arm of T section as well as series arm of pi section of low pass filter, so that we will get the attenuation characteristics Z0 will be same at all frequencies. Okay, so that derivation we got, that is Z2 dash related to T section and Z1 dash related to pi section. So the modification circuit or modification filter, we can call it as M derived low pass filter. So after that, we have derived the equation of the constant, we can say that will be the M. So what will be the formula for M for low pass filter? It should be M is equal to under root 1 minus fc, fc divided by f alpha bracket square. Okay, so fc means cutoff frequency of low pass filter and f alpha means the resonant frequency in the shunt arm, because shunt arm consisting of inductor as well as capacitor connected in series, and that will forms the series resonance circuit. Whenever the series resonance circuit is there or parallel resonance circuit is there, it is having its own resonant frequency. So that resonant frequency is denoted as F alpha, and Fc is cutoff frequency of low pass filter. So from these, if you are putting the values, then you will get the M, and if you are getting the value of M, then it will be easy to get the values of elements in the series arm as well as shunt arm of pi section as well as T section in case of M derived low pass filter. So yesterday also we have discussed about the design of M derived low pass filter. Mainly in the university they are asking the problems. So in the problem we require the three formulas. First, the formula we require to calculate the small m is equal to under root 1 minus fc divided by f alpha bracket square. For low pass filter, if they are asking low pass filter, we have to write the equations of constant k type low pass filter as it is. So for constant k type low pass filter, L is equal to k upon pi into fc, and c is equal to just k take in the denominator, 1 upon k into pi into fc. So these three formulas we require to solve the problems based on the M derived low pass filter. So today we are solving the problem. We will solve this one problem based on the M derived low pass filter, and after that we are going to start the theoretical part of M derived high pass filter, and lastly we will solve the problem based on M derived high pass filter. So today this part we have to complete. Now take down the problem based on this. So this type of problem will also ask for 4 marks, or sometimes they will ask for 6 marks, but mainly such type of problem they will ask for 6 marks in the question number 5. So I will write that question. First of all, carefully read the question and then you can start. Design M derived low pass filter. Design M derived low pass filter having cutoff frequency. Having cutoff frequency of 1 kilohertz, comma, design impedance of 400 ohm, and the resonant frequency of 1100 hertz. So one thing you have to just check: in M derived low pass filter, resonant frequency should be greater than cutoff frequency. Cutoff frequency kiti dile 1 kilohertz, means 1000 hertz, and resonant frequency is 1100 hertz. Yes, the condition is satisfying. Okay, now next, when we are reading the question, what they are expecting, we are going to design M derived low pass filter. So first of all, what you can do, which filter you are going to design, that you can note down, that is M derived low pass filter. M derived low pass filter. So after that, what are the given things you can note down? So design impedance means value of K, that is given 400 ohm. Okay, next, cutoff frequency they have given, that is FC is equal to, either you can write 1K or you can simply write 1000 hertz. Next, F alpha, that is the resonant frequency they have given. So resonant frequency is 1100. Some students may write 1 kilohertz and this they can write 1.1 kilohertz. Ekter he doni combination teva kiwa he. So you can choose it, whichever you can feel easy, you can put it. Both are same. If you are putting 1000, you can put here 1100. If you are putting here 1K, you can put 1.1K. Now next, they are asking M derived low pass filter. So you can start with finding out value of M. So what is the equation of M? So that is 1 minus FC divided by F alpha bracket square. So always remember, many students are getting confusion here. In case of low pass filter, in the numerator FC will be there. So put the values here. 1 minus, so FC is 1K divided by 1.1K bracket square. So KK will get cancelled, that is 10 raised to 3. So calculate and tell now value. Take the calculator, do it and tell what will be the value of small m. What is the value? No. Yes. 0.416. That is correct. The value of M is always greater than 0 and less than 1. Remember, the value of M is always greater than 0 and less than 1. So M we got 0.416. Next, second one, for low pass filter, the value of L is equal to, what is the formula for L for low pass filter? You have to take the formulas of constant K type low pass filter. So L is equal to K upon pi FC. So put the values. K is 400 divided by pi into, that is 1K, kiwa 1000 liu shakta. And till now value L is equal to kiti yate baga, in terms of milli you can tell, milli H, milli Henry. Henry, okay, or in terms of milli Henry, it is 127.32 milli H, 127.32 milli H, that is the value of L. Shift the 3 point. Now next, third one, the value of capacitor C is equal to 1 upon K into pi into FC. So put the values, 1 upon 400 into pi into 1000. Calculate and tell the value of capacitor C in terms of microfarad. You can tell. Okay, very good. That is 0.795 microfarad. So this is the answer of capacitor C. So if you are doing up to this step, it per in the solve killer, then out of 6 you will get minimum 2 marks. If you are doing up to this, out of 6 you will get minimum 2 marks. जर 4 मार्काला विचारला असेल तर 1.5 मार्क्स यू विल गेट. इफ इट आर आस्किंग फॉर 4 मार्क्स यू विल गेट 1.5 मार्क्स. सो एनी प्रॉब्लेम इन दिस अप टू दिस पॉइंट, सिंपल यू हैव टू पुट द वैल्यूज, बट द कंडीशन इज दैट यू शुड नो द फॉर्मुलेज करेक्टली. या दोन फॉर्मुलेला तर काही अडचण नाही, बिकॉज ऑलरेडी यू लर्न द लो पास फिल्टर. जस्ट रिमेंबर द वैल्यू ऑफ एम और इक्वेशन ऑफ एम, अंडरस्टूड? So up to this, there will not be any problem for any student. Now next, so after calculating value of m, value of l and c, so you can draw the t section as well as pi section of m derived low pass filter. So t section I will draw first of all. So t section consisting of, as it is low pass filter, inductor in series and in parallel inductor and capacitor are in parallel arm or shunt arm, inductor and capacitor are connected in series. So this is a T section M derived low pass filter. Okay, so pi section I will draw. In the pi section, the series arm consisting of parallel resonance circuit. This is the inductor connected in parallel with capacitor. So the shunt arm consisting of capacitor okay. Now here the values we have to write. So what will be the value of this one for M derived T section low pass filter? It is M L by 2, M L by 2, M L by 2. Okay, now this capacitor is, what is the capacitor value? Now here we can write what is the name of this one? M into C, and this one is 1 minus m square divided by 4 m into l. हे व्हॅल्यूज तुम्हाला लक्षात ठेवावंच लागेल. ओके, देर इज नो ऑप्शन, यू हॅव टू रिमेंबर ओनली. सो नेक्स्ट, हियर ॲज युजल इट इज एम सी बाय 2, एम सी बाय 2. नाव नेक्स्ट, इंडक्टर अँड कॅपॅसिटर. हियर फॉर इंडक्टर इट इज एम इंटू एल, and for capacitor it is 1 minus m square divided by 4 m into c. So once you are writing all those values, you can calculate all these values and then put in the diagram. So I will write here, this is the figure A, this will show T section, T section, and this will show the pi section. So T section and pi section of what? That you can write figure, that is M derived low pass filter. M derived low pass filter. So up to this, if you are drawing the diagram correctly, out of 6 you will get 3 marks. Okay, 3 to 4 marks you can get. 4 marks you can say. Out of 6, 4 marks you can get. Means calculation of M, L and C as well as the correct diagram with names. If you are doing up to this, you will get the 4 marks out of 6. And out of 4, you will get 3 marks. Now, the next task will be calculating the value of M, L by 2, M into C, this value, then M into L, then this value, and then finally this one. Means totally 6 values nearby, 6 values you have to calculate, 5 to 6 values you have to calculate. I think 6 only. So first of all, I will calculate ML is required. So M into L, that is m value, we got 0.416 into what is the value of L, that is 127.32 millih. So calculate and tell ml. ml is 52.96 millih. You can cross check, take the calculator and find out. We will, what we can do, we will consider for pi section. Pehla pi section matlab calculate karuya. Pi section manje ml, this value and this value. Okay, now next, second one, mc divided by 2, m into c divided by 2, that is m is 0.416 into capacitor c value is 0.795 microfarad divided by 2. So calculate and tell what you are getting. M into c divided by 2. Micro means what? 10 raised to minus 6. Or you can put as it is. So you are getting now here 0.165 microfarad. Please anyone cross check whether we are get, whether whatever I written that will be the correct or not. Next, yes, next third one will be this value. You can calculate 1 minus m square divided by 4m into c. So this value you can calculate. 1 minus m square means 0.416 bracket square divided by 4 into 0.416 into capacitor c value is 0.795 micro. So calculate and tell what should be the value. I got this as 0.395 microfarad. So please cross check all these three values. Calculation you have to do correctly. There will not be any option. Calculation chukla, then it's your fault, your mistake. So calculation part you can do properly. So this is completed about the pi section. Now next for T section. T section madhe kay kay calculation hai, that you can calculate. So in the T section, ml by 2, then m into c, and then 1 minus m square divided by 4m into l, that is required. So first we are calculating ml by 2. So you can do the smart work here. M into l already calculated, that is 52.96 mH. So make it divided by 2. So that is 26.48 mH. Already M into L calculated. So do the smart work. Make it divided by 2. Don't put value of M, L and then 2. Okay. Already we have calculated M, L. So 26.48 mH. Next, second one. Second one. M into C. M into C. So M into C divided by 2 you have calculated. That is 0.165. Make it multiply into 4. Multiply it to 2, sorry. He calculate kele na, multiply 2 kele ki 2 to cancel hoto. That you will get M into C. So 0.165 into 2 you can just 2 micro. 0.165 micro into 2, that is nearly equal to 0.330 microfarad. Or you can put the value of m and then c and do it by using calculator. Next, third one, 1 minus m square divided by 4m into l. So if you calculated this part, multiply into l, you will get the answer of that. So I will put here 1 minus 0.416 bracket square divided by 4 into 0.416 into L. L value is 127.32 milli. calculate and tell. So this will be, I got 63.27. In this way, I got all the six values, 3 from pi section and 3 from t section. Once you got all those values, please mention in the diagram. Okay, so that part, that will give a last mark. Don't calculate and calculate, and if you are not putting in the diagram, you will lose the one mark. So m into l, that is the 52.96, I will write 52.96 mH. Next, m into c divided by 2, that is 0.165 microfarad, 0.165 microfarad, 0.165 microfarad. So next, 1 minus m square divided by 4m into c, that value I got 0.395 microfarad, 0.395 microfarad. Okay, now pi section is over. Come to the t section. T section ML by 2, that is 26.48 mH. Now M into C, that is 0.33 microfarad. This will be 0.33 microfarad. And last, 1 minus M square into L divided by 4M, that is 63.27 mH. Understood? So once you are putting all those values, you can complete the diagram, that is design part. So any doubt in this? Kai Adson in M derived low pass filter? Please reply so that we can start the next part. What will be the changes in the question? They can give the different value of K. They can give the different value of cutoff frequency. They can give the different value of resonant frequency. This much will be the change. Remaining all it is same. Or sometimes they will give value of M directly. Kai problem with the value of M detat directly. There need not be calculate to M. Directly you can start with L and C. So any doubt, once again I am asking, so that I will start the high pass filter, M derived high pass filter. Okay, so we have finished now M derived low pass filter. So we will start now M derived high pass filter. When it will stop, you can once again rejoin everyone. So next part, M derived high pass filter. So first of all, what I will do, I will draw the T section as well as pi section of this M derived high pass filter. Then we will start to discuss. So in the high pass filter, in the series arm, always capacitor is there. We know that because we have learned the constant K type high pass filter. In the shunt arm, the inductor was there, but here there will be the modification. So modification with respect to what? Shunt arm of the T section and series arm of the pi section. So here, instead of inductor, there will be a series combination of inductor and capacitor. So this will be the T section of M derived high pass filter. And in the pi section, there will be the modification in the series arm. There will be the capacitor only in case of constant K-type high pass filter. But here, the inductor will be present in parallel with capacitor. So there will be the parallel combination of inductor and capacitor, so that it will form the parallel resonance circuit in the series arm. Now shunt arm consisting of inductor as usual, because in high pass filter the shunt arm consisting of inductor. Okay, so I will write the value now here. So what will be the value in case of constant K type high pass filter? That will be 2C. Understood? 2C, 2C and 2C. But here it will be now 2C by M. This will be 2C by M. Next, when inductor was there, there will be, what will be the value of inductor? Only L. So here it will be L by M. Next, capacitor is added here, the new modification. That will be 4M divided by 1 minus M square into C. So what will be the modification compared with M derived low pass filter? Exactly reciprocal. Tikda kay asaycha 1 minus M square divided by 4M asaycha. Ata ikta exactly ulta. 4M divided by 1 minus M square. Now similarly here, for inductor, whenever the inductor are connected in parallel, we are taking 2L in case of constant K type high pass filter. Now here divided by M, divided by M. Now next, capacitor whenever present in only in series arm, we are taking just C. So C is replaced by C by M in case of constant K type high pass filter. Now inductor is added here, the new modification. So that will be 4M divided by 1 minus M square into L. So whatever the modification is there, here capacitor is added, here inductor is added. So 4M divided by 1 minus M square remains same. Into C because of capacitor, 4M divided by 1 minus M square, that will be the remain same, into L because of inductor. That you can just remember. So next one, I will take this as a T section, and this figure B denotes the pi section. So this total figure will represent the M derived high pass filter. M derived high pass filter. M derived high pass filter. Now, we are getting the equation of small m. So there will be the small derivation, and we will see what are the design equations we require. And once we will get the design equations, then we are going to solve the problem based on the M derived high pass filter. So first of all, how to get the small M value? For that, there will be the derivation. So we'll start that part. Consider both M derived high pass, consider both M derived high pass filter T section and pi section as shown in figure. Okay, now next, what will be the modification in the T section in the shunt arm, and what will be the modification in the pi section in the series arm? So that we can take any one, you can take either T section or pi section. Suppose I am taking the T section, so what will be there will be the change we can write. If shunt arm in T section, if shunt arm in T section is series resonance circuit, obviously because L and R are connected in series, this will represent the series resonance circuit. If shunt arm in T section is series resonance circuit, then it has इट हैज मिनिमम इम्पिडन्स. सीरीज रेजोनन्स मध्ये काय असतो, ऍट इम्पिडन्स देअर विल बी द मिनिमम व्हॅल्यू ऑफ इम्पिडन्स, दॅट इज ओनली आर ऍक्च्युअली. ओके, आर इज नॉट देअर, सो इट इज नियरली झिरो. देन इट हॅज मिनिमम ऑर नियरली, आय विल राईट झिरो, मिनिमम इम्पिडन्स बिकॉज आर आर इज नॉट प्रेझेंट. देअरफोर देअरफोर द आउटपुट देअरफोर द आउटपुट इज झिरो ॲट रेझोनंट फ्रिक्वेन्सी. At resonant frequency, and due to which, and due to which, infinite attenuation will get at resonant frequency. Zero output means totally attenuated the output means. We are getting infinite attenuation. Infinite means we can talk about 100%. 100% attenuation we will get at the resonant frequency. So at the resonant frequency, what will be the condition of resonance? XL is equal to XC. So that I will write XL is equal to XC. That is at resonance. At resonant frequency we can talk. At resonant frequency F alpha. XL is equal to XC. XL is equal to XC. So what is XL? That is L by M. And what is XC? That is, you can consider this vector. So XL is equal to omega alpha as it is into L. So L is actually L by M. So that is L by M is equal to 1 upon omega alpha into. So capacitor is replaced by this value. That is 4M into C divided by 1 minus M square. So this M and this M will get cancelled. Okay. So omega R alpha you can take in the one side, that is becomes omega alpha square is equal to 1 minus M square go into the numerator, 1 minus M square divided by 4 into L into C. Okay. Omega alpha square is equal to 1 minus M square goes to the numerator and this L will join with multiplication of C. So 4 into L into C. So omega alpha is equal to, take the square root on both hand side. Doni kanna square root gya. So if you are taking the square root on both hand side, so omega alpha is equal to 1 minus M square, under root 1 minus M square divided by what will come? 2 into under root LC. Okay, so what is omega alpha? That is 2 pi f alpha is equal to under root 1 minus m square divided by 2 into under root LC. So 2 pi you can take here, so that f alpha becomes 1 minus m square under root 1 minus m square divided by 4 pi into under root LC. So this is the formula of f alpha. But for high pass filter, once again I will show you. So here we got M square is equal to this one. So we got M is equal to under root 1 minus F alpha divided by FC bracket square. So in case of high pass filter, the resonant frequency of F alpha is always less than cutoff frequency of FC of high pass filter. So exactly opposite for the low pass filter. So don't confuse the formulas here. Always remember whatever you are writing in the numerator, that will be small compared with the denominator. So which is the greater in low pass filter and which is the greater in high pass filter, that you can carefully remember. Now next, design of M derived high pass filter. So what are the three formulas we require for the designing of M derived high pass filter? So first of all, we require the value of m. So how to calculate that? That will be under root 1 minus f alpha divided by fc bracket square. Second one, for constant k-type high-pass filter, that is for HPF, the value of L is equal to K upon 4 pi FC, and value of third will be the value of C. C is equal to 1 upon K into 4 pi into FC. So these three formulas we require for the design of M-derived high-pass filter, small m, value of L, and value of C. So can we stop today? Because to solve the problem, we requires minimum 15 to 20 minutes. So that part we will consider in the next lecture. That is the design of M-derived high-pass filter. Okay. We'll stop now. In the next lecture, we are going to discuss about or we can solve the problems based on this M-derived high-pass filter. And after that, we are going to start the attenuator part. Filter part will over now. Only one problem is remaining. Once we can complete that filter part, we will start the attenuator part. Okay? Chalo. Thank you.